This is the Giannini Craviola, a unique Brazilian-made instrument made famous by Jimmy Page. Today we'll be taking a look at this instrument, looking into the company's history, and ultimately seeing what it can do. If that sounds like something you'd be interested in, stick around. Heidi Ho there again, boys and girls, and welcome to yet another edition of Live from the Tape Farm. Today we're going to be taking a look at the Giannini Craviola, which is a really unique acoustic instrument, guitar-based. It has a little bit of a different kind of flair to it. Obviously, the body shape alone is very unique, and the idea behind that was to kind of get a cross between two different instruments, two different Brazilian instruments. This is actually was designed by a guitar player by the name of Paulino Nogueira. And I'm sorry if I'm mispronouncing names, but I'm barely good with English, so Brazilian Portuguese is not going to be my strong suit. So Paulino Nogueira designed the instrument, and then it was built by Giannini back in the early 70s, started out as a classical guitar, and then there were 6-strings and 12-string versions made, which is when Jimmy Page found them and then famously used them on Tangerine. Also rumored that the 12-string was the 12-string that was used on Stairway to Heaven. So that's the rumor, or at least what I've been able to dig up. So the Giannini Guitar Company actually started back in 1900, and even on the headstock, you can see there where it says 1900. So it was started back in 1900 by Tranquillo Giannini, who was actually an Italian immigrant to Brazil. Started making guitars and the company just took off. By the 1930s, they were making so many guitars, they had to start making their own strings because nobody could make strings fast enough for them. So it's a very popular guitar throughout Brazil. If you were to look at the company's website, there's tons of places in Brazil you can buy them, and that's about it. So finding them outside of Brazil, it's not impossible, but they're unique. They're not something you see every day. So how did I come across this? How did I get interested in this guitar? So oddly enough, it was not from Jimmy Page, of all things. It was actually, I went to a Renaissance Festival here in Nashville. Every year there is a Renaissance Festival. And one of the guys there who performed there numerous years plays one of these guitars. The instrument just sounds amazing. And so after his performance, I spoke to him briefly and he told me a little bit about the guitar and where it came from and so on and so forth. So I went on a quest and found one that I was interested in buying and got it. So I purchased this off of Reverb. I think it was about $800, somewhere in that range. And it really is a stunning instrument. The construction of it is outstanding. So spruce top, Brazilian rosewood back and sides. I think it's a mahogany neck, but I'm not 100% sure, but Brazilian rosewood on the fretboard. And then the binding, there's just maple binding all around the guitar, around the body, on the neck. I mean, it's just stunning. And the abalone around the sound hole, really an amazing, amazing instrument. And acoustically, I mean, it just sounds great. In the room, it sounds fantastic. Putting mics on it, they sound great. And it even sounds great direct, plugged in. It has some Fishman electronics in it, and those are stellar. I can plug this guy in. I mean, it sounds great. So the demo I'm gonna be doing in a little bit is gonna be a mix of both mic and direct. So you'll kind of get a taste of what the guitar can do. It has its own kind of voice. It's a guitar, obviously, but it's got something a little extra going on for it. So let's take a peek at what it can do.
Mm-hmm.
Alrighty, so that is our look at the Giannini Craviola. Fantastic instruments. Basically, it's one of those dream instruments. Like one of these days, I hope I can get, and I happen to be able to get it. So this will never leave me. For as long as I'm here, it will be with me. So an amazing, amazing guitar, and one that I am very, very privileged to own. And it sounds fantastic, and it records great. Pretty much everything I've been looking for in a six-string acoustic. So it's kind of hard to beat. That's all I got for you today. Questions, comments, concerns? Rise above! Hit me up in the comments below, and we'll catch you guys later.